All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming live from beautiful Portland, Oregon, out here on the West Coast, trying to break it all down for you guys. We got to talk about basketball. It is time to transition. We got our football season out of the way. It's everybody's favorite. I get it. But it's time to transition, and we're going to have plenty of football talk. I'll still be in here. I'll be doing the live streams as much as I can on Tuesdays, 5:30 to 7:30. Still talk about football. Still talk about recruiting. Talk about transfer portal. Guys coming, guys staying. Whatever the case may be, but we got to talk about basketball. Basketball is the season right now. And it's a very important one because this Duck team looks good. I didn't know how this team would round out. I had faith in Dana. As a guy who, as a sports fan my whole life, basketball is my number one favorite sport, always has been. It's the sport I played the most for the longest amount of time. It's also the sport I've coached the longest. And I love the game. I break it down as much as I can. I feel like I know what I'm talking about. I come from a lot of different perspective. I dig really deep into it. I watch a lot of college basketball. I watch NBA. I watch international ball, whatever I get a chance to. High school sports, obviously, as a high school educator. So this team has a unique, unique opportunity. In a year where, excuse me, I need some medical grade water real quick. In a year where, thank you. The Pac-12 is in its last year, and you're going to see these teams for the last time. Things look fairly open. Arizona has looked like the clear number one. Now they look like they're beatable. If they're beatable, I think Oregon finds itself possibly in that next tier of teams that are looking to get into this thing. And teams like Colorado and Utah, always a problem. Washington has played very well this year. Washington State's always a problem to play, especially up there in Pullman, like we got to do Saturday. So this is a big time. USC and UCLA are both kind of down right now, historically, to where they've been. And the Ducks have some losses. They lost to Santa Clara. They lost to Alabama. They lost to Syracuse. As of right now, that's a really good record. With this team, with the injuries this team's had, not having Infale this whole time, having Nate go out, having a variety of different players go out and not have the opportunity to have your full team together at the same time. You've had to lean on Jermaine. You've had to lean on Keyshawn. You've had your guards. You've had to lean on Kira Aquendo, a variety of different other guys. And, you know, it's really interesting how this team is shaping into form. Now you're going to get Mookie Cook back. You're going to finally see Mookie. Jackson's been the guy. Looks like the best player on the team when he's been playing well. And, you know, you have something with a really nice, quick, penetrating point guard that you haven't had since basically Peyton. There's been some point guards that look to shoot and they want to stay on the outside. You need the big, dribble down, heavy, penetrating point guard to really get this action moving offensively. Jackson's got that beautiful step-down pull-up jumper that I'm assuming has been very much influenced by Peyton, also helped to be coached by Peyton in that same vein, because that's what Peyton has, that same thing in his bag. But now Brennan Rigsby's played a lot better this year, has really added up to his role. You've got some great things going with Kwame Evans Jr. This is a really unique team. And over the last couple weeks now, it looks like your two best players are the freshmen, which are awesome because Jermaine Cousinard, Keaton Barthelemy, you know what you have with those guys. Very solid. Aquendo looks great. Okay. The rest of the guys who they've brought in here have looked very good. And it just looks like a team that's really open and the opportunity is there for them. I can't say enough about this team has to defend and rebound. Dana's teams always have to defend and rebound. Tracy's been a huge pickup. He's played big minutes with these guys being out. If Mookie can come in here and play some defense, then I think you're on to something. Jackson's been pretty good defensively, but this is a really wild season. So Washington, with their zone and their quirkiness that they have, they're always a problem. They're so unique the way that they play the game. They've always got length. They've always got guys who can fill it up. They've always got really good guard play. So I'm really interested to see how this game against Washington is going to be. Washington historically has been a team that has been up and down. And over the last couple years, they've been more down than up. But Keon Brooks, man, has been playing very well. And, you know, these guys are putting it in. And Frank Kepnong has got himself going a little bit as well. They've had some interesting games. Now, they've lost to Nevada. They've lost to San Diego State. They've lost to Colorado and Utah back-to-back. But both those games were close. The Utah game was up and down, 95-90. And the Colorado game was a classic Colorado game, 73-69. And so, you know, you beat Gonzaga. That's the biggest win of your whole schedule. You have a huge game against Gonzaga. You beat Gonzaga, 78-73. And now you've got a really interesting schedule ahead of you. If the Huskies can do well against the Ducks and the Beavs this weekend, they're going to find themselves on the top of this conference. If Oregon goes up there and sweep the Washington schools, Oregon's going to be the number one team in this conference. So, again, I am really impressed with how they've kind of managed to get this thing where it's at. Next week, they have no game in the middle of the week, and they've got Cal, which is an interesting one. Because, again, Cal is one of those teams that they are what they are. They've got a really good coach, and they feel like they're a team that they could get you on any night. And so I'm really interested to see what Cal's got going on. So, and then after that, you know, you've got a really interesting situation because you got to go up to the Mountain Schools. Mountain Schools historically been a very big problem, especially Colorado. So, you know, historically, that's been a loss. There's not been many wins up there. And when you have the Washington games right before it and then the Cal game, if Oregon wins these games and they've got themselves in a situation where they're undefeated in conference, how horrible would it be to go up to Colorado with that and take a loss right there? Oh, gosh. So hopefully Mfale comes back around that time and Mookie plays really well this weekend and you get things going. I still think Jermaine Cousinard's your best player on this team. He's so dynamic. He's a guard that can post. He's really strong. He's good defensively. He's good rebounding. He's got a great knack for the ball. He's got a good shot. He's got a green light. He's willing to take it. But I do think right now Jackson Shelstead's playing better than anybody on this team. And if you're the straw that stirs the drink and you're the point guard, good things are going to happen for you and for the rest of the team. So it's all about, to me, that relationship between those freshmen. Kwame Evans Jr., Jackson Shelstead, build that relationship from the ground up starting right now. Mookie Cook is now going to enter that fold. You got the three freshmen. Really, really good recruiting class. You blend these guys in with some of these guys who you brought in on the transfer portal. And then you start to have them play with some bigs. You know, Mohamed Diawara has been playing very well for his level, but he's not a scorer. He's definitely a big. He's there to block some shots, and he's there to have some height. But he can't do it. And so you need to have Mfale come back. He's the guy. And if this team that was really focused on dumping it down and playing with their big men first, and they had to relearn the game and kind of look for a guard dominant. I mean, they beat UCLA the other night. And they were playing five guards. Tracy was the five. Tracy was on Bona at the five. And Bona was crushing the Ducks earlier with Ware or with Diawara. So, so I'm just so impressed with Dana again. Dana aligns Rubik's Cubes. We know the storyline. Had a lot of ups and downs. Feels like they're on the way back up again. And if you put this thing together with enough youth and enough veteran leadership, this could be a very special team. Not to mention the fact that when you start to look at the rest of this conference, like I said before, the rest of the conference looks fairly gettable. And if you can get this conference early, you can get a real handle on it going forward. I think that's the most important thing to understand. I mean, historically, the teams that do well in the first part of the schedule are the ones that usually find themselves in the upper end of the bracket going to Vegas for the Pac-12 tournament. Usually the teams that play well in January are the teams that end up there. Now, we've seen teams buck the trend. We've seen Oregon struggle early and get better late. We've seen a variety of other teams do this, but chances are, if you start winning games now, you're going to be there at the end. Colorado winning two games, Utah winning two games, the Ducks having two games, Arizona State having two games under their belt with no losses. And like I said, those first two teams, Colorado and Utah, are both 11-2 right now in their overall. That's saying something. So the Mountain schools look very strong. The LA schools look weaker. LA is not looking good right now. UCLA is 6-8 right now. USC is 6-7. These are not good records right now. Okay? And Arizona, the team that was the clear number one, is now 10-3. So the Ducks and the Arizona Wildcats right now have the same overall record. And the Ducks have a better record in conference. Arizona losing to Stanford their night. Stanford going on a crazy run of threes and beating Arizona. Arizona now sits at 1-1 in conference. So, again, crazy stuff happened. And Arizona is going to need to get some wins right now to stay afloat here. Otherwise, it could get dicey for them. And this conference is up for the taking. So I love the fact that Oregon's in the conversation right now, and I think they're going to remain in the conversation. It's just whether or not they can get through this weekend against the Huskies and the Cougs. We know the Oregon-Husky rivalry has been alive and well in basketball and football. Let's see if we can take it to basketball as well, all right? All right, y'all. Thank you for watching Sports Chat 503. Again, thanks so much. Basketball, I know a lot of people kind of fall off a little bit with the football to basketball interest. So thank you so much for watching, and stay with us for basketball. Thank you guys again. Go Ducks.